Fastly, okay. You can see the screen now. I'm sure about it, I guess. Okay. First of all, I would like to say welcome for everyone. My name is Hakan. I'm working for Mavil Electronic Company. And today I'm going to talk about fire alarm system integration with peripheral systems and project principles. What is it used for? Our references and modules. When we are preparing this presentation, we based on EN54 standards, EN5418 input-output modules, EN54-4, power and supply equipments, EN5414, planning, design, installation, commissioning, use and maintenance. And I will talk about modules, and in the part of the modules, I will talk about GCU panel, SGC cards, smoke damper control panel, firefighters telephone control unit, and announce alarm matrix panel. Okay, what is it? What is the integration used for? It is used for the integrated operation of CCTV, emergency announcement, card pass, smoke evacuation control systems, and for the other systems, you can use our integration modules. So let's talk about GCU panel. I think I was in here when the sharing is cut. Okay, let's talk about GCU panel. It is used for the communication with supervisor software, or it is used for communication with other building management system with thanks to Modbus and BACnet outputs. There is 6 outputs. 2 of them is for other building management systems, BACnet and Modbus, and there is also 4 output: RS232, RS485 cable, GPRS module and TCP/IP module. You can pick one of them. We will edit, or you can choose all of them, but it is unnecessary. And we suggest that you should do it with TCP/IP protocol, because you don't need any cable, and you can communicate with our supervisor software wherever you want. And as you can see on this image, for the from your network structure, if you want to monitor it, your network structure for the other panels, 64 panels you can connect in one network panel, one network structure. And if you want to monitor it from far away the building with PC, with computer, you can use our supervisor software to monitor and control the network structure. And you should use GCU panel for it. Also, we have another option. I will talk about it. Okay, let's continue. For the communication protocol, GCU module is used for communication of fire alarm control panels and the computer where the supervisor program is installed. There is a 4 different way you can communicate with panels to PC with via GCU module. RS cables, RS232, maximum 15 meter you can connect it. For with RS485 cable, you can maximize it with 1.2 kilometer. With TCP/IP protocol, you don't need any cable, and it is without any distance, because communication is provided via LAN or WAN. And also GPRS module, you can use it. There is also no distance restriction. But you should remember the you need to pay your bill, because if you don't pay your bill for the GSM card, it cannot send any SMS or any other things. It happened from last years. It's happened. That's why I'm warning it about it. So let's talk about SGC module. So what is it used for? If you don't want to use panels in network structure, for example, you have 40 panel, but you don't want it in network structure. You want to install it by standalone for each panel. You can use SGC module to monitor it from PC. It is, you can think about like these SGC modules are, for example, small GCU panels. It is used for the communication via with panel to PC. And there is also a four-way to use it. RS cables, you can use it. TCP/IP modules, UART communication protocol and UART cable. And also GPRS module. But we are recommending, again, TCP/IP cards. Also, as I mentioned before, with GCU panel, you can control other building management systems with Modbus and BACnet. It is an example structure of SGC and GCU modules. Can everybody hear me? Is there any problem? Ah, okay. Again, screen. Okay, I saw it. Now, you can see it, right? Okay, great. As you can see on this image, this is an example of SGC and GCU panel structures and for example. Sorry about it. Okay, with SGC cards, you should put it in network card location, okay? If you use SGC card, you cannot use network card. If you use network cards, you cannot use SGC cards. It is, if you want to use it standalone for the panels, and if you want to communicate it with our supervisor software, you should use SGC cards with TCP/IP protocol, okay? But if you use GCU panel, you can put network cards on the panel, because GCU panels are different panel, but SGC is a card and you should put it on the, in the panel. This is an example of SGC card. It is like a network card and you should put it on the panel network card location. Communication protocols are almost same. Just the difference is with GCU module you can use GPRS, but with SGC module you cannot use it. You can use UART, TCP/IP and RS cables communications. With UART it is maximum 2 meters for the communication distance with panel and computer. Okay, let's talk about smoke damper panels. It is used for controlling the smoke dampers. We have some options on it. As you can see in here, there is a toggle switch. You can use it in manually, or if you put it in automatic mode, it will be in automatic. But if you want to open it manually, there is an also options with open and close and automatic. Also, you can connect them together, and it should be connect with to panel. Also, you can control smoke damper panels with supervisor software. There is an option on the supervisor software. You can control it in remotely with our software. Okay, then let's talk about firefighters telephone control unit. It is firefighter telephone control unit. In case of emergency, it enables authorized people to communicate with firefighter field phones and security center or other field phones. Okay. Can you hear me now? Okay, I guess everything is okay now. I'm continuing with firefighter telephone control unit. In case of an emergency, it enables authorized persons to communicate with firefighter field phones and security center or other field phones. It is a block diagram of firefighter telephone telephone control unit and firefighter telephones. You can connect maximum 32 firefighter telephones for one firefighter telephone control unit. It is for emergency situations for the firefighters to communicate on the field when there is a fire situation. Okay, then let's talk about Announce Alarm Matrix Panel. The Announce Alarm Matrix Panels that provide integration with the announcement system in U3U rack structure. We are providing Announce Alarm Matrix Panel. We are not providing this part about the sounders, speakers, amplifiers, other parts. We are providing Announce Alarm Matrix Panel. In case of fire, it is sending announce signals to amplifiers and other speaker parts. It is for integration with announcement system to fire alarm system. Okay. There are one of unit of announce power module inside of the Announce Alarm Matrix Panel as an internal power supply, and one unit of announce output module to provide sound signal output as a standard. There are 16 units of module input socket and announce input modules and programmable alert output module can be installed to the socket. Okay. Up to 4 units of announce modules can be connected to each announce input module. There are 8 outputs for each programmable alert output module. This panel is compatible with MaxLogic series analog addressable fire alarm panels. It is able to activate all desired relay outputs with using programmable alert output modules included cause effect scenarios at event of for example fire, fault or any situation, which situation you want. Live announcement feature via presented announce system to the determined areas by authorized people is provided with using internal announce module on ML125 series panels, the red panels, addressable fire alarm panels at fire and emergency situation. As you know, we have only one option for Announce Alarm Matrix Panel. You should use red panel because we have options on red panel, printer options, Announce Alarm Matrix, Announce Alarm Module and other integration, firefighter telephone control unit on it. 3 options on our red panels. When fire situation occurs, using announce alarm, alert output modules and automatic announce with pre-recorded messages or sound records via presented announce system can be provided to determined areas. Okay, let's talk about related standard articles. We took these articles from EN54 standards. For the theoretically ant network systems, theoretically systems are often used where a main site is divided into several small pieces. For example, in shopping malls, large hospitals or campus areas. When several separate buildings are found on a common site, each may need its own system for fire detection and alarm, but must transmit status information to the center in the facility. Cable economy in large buildings can be achieved by using several auxiliary control indicator equipments, each providing fire detection and alarm functions for a particular part of building, but additionally communicating with and within a building within in the building. Control and indicator. In general, control and indicator of panel must be provided the EN54-2 standard requirements. Location of control and indicating equipments. Equipment, example of control and indicator panels, repeater panels or fire alarm panels, together with appropriate manual control facilities, must be placed in a suitable place for personnel and firefighters interfering with fire control. This should be normally be available for use in firefighting and rescue service in a properly located control room. Located on ground floor near the entrance of the building, which is likely to be used by the fire and rescue service, or at least in a properly operating control room, allowing the first control and any fire in the incident to be checked by the staff. In complex structures, the user or buyer should consult with fire and rescue service on the placement of all control and indicator equipment. Where there are multiple entrances to a complex structure, fire control and service equipment needs to be consulted to determine the possible need for repeater and indicating equipment. Note that there may be national legislation regarding to acceptance of location of control and indicating equipment by the firefighting department. Control and indicating equipment should be placed at a height that does not require the use of mechanical access equipment, allowing all indicators to be seen and operating control functions. The height of the screen and indicators should be at least 89 centimeter above to floor level in desktop applications. In all other applications, the height of the display and indicators from the finished floor level should be at least 1.4 meter and at most 1.8 meter. Care should be taken to ensure that the angle of view is easily readable by all operators and responsible persons. When there is a special need, to provision of duplicate controls and screens should be considered. Control and indicating equipment should be placed in a normally accessible living area, preferably when the building is used. Where this is not possible, a simple remote display device or a means for transmitting signals to the responsible person should be provided in normally accessible living area. If the control and indicating equipment is far from the entrance used by firefighting department, there are signs that direct the control and indicating equipment to the locations. Conditions for the room where the control and indicating equipment is located. Room with control and indicating equipment, there should be a small risk of fire. Be protected at least one fire detector in the system. Be clean and dry. The risk of mechanical damage to the equipment must be low. Be large enough so that people who operate or maintain control and indication equipment are not restricted. It must have sufficient illumination so that the visual indicators can be clearly seen, easily controlled, and any instructions or descriptions can be easily read. If necessarily, additional artificial lighting should be provided to provide the appropriate lighting level. Emergency lighting should be on access roads to control and indicating equipment and repeater panels. There should be an ambient noise that does not prevent audible alarms from being heard. For the other systems and for other device and systems, in addition to the main purpose detection and alarm signals from the system can be used to trigger auxiliary devices directly or indirectly, such as fire extinguishing equipment, smoke or fire doors, smoke ventilation equipment, smoke or fire dampers, shutting of ventilation, elevator control, safety doors, operation or malfunction of auxiliary devices should not compromise the operation of fire detection system or prevent it from signaling other auxiliary devices. Operation of other fire protection systems. The fire detection and alarm system can be used to provide start signals to other fire protection systems, such as automatic fire extinguishing systems, smoke and heat control systems, systems that trigger the release and closing of fire doors, sound evacuation system. Note that European product standards and installation guidelines will apply to some of these systems. The operation or malfunction of another fire protection system should not compromise the proper functioning of the fire detection and alarm system or prevent the transmission of a signal to another system. Application at special risk. Special risks are those that require special attention and knowledge in the design and selection of equipment. The placement of detectors and the arrangement of circuits or between them. Among such risks are, for example, electronic data processing areas, high rack warehouses, high selling areas, dangerous areas, outdoor risks, high value risks. And limitation of fault effects. the design of the system should be such that the effects of faults in cables and interconnections are limited. Two alternative approaches to fault effect limitation are possible. Cables without fire resistance. A single fault in transmission path should not prevent more than one of the following functions from working correctly in area such that manual start function, automatic fire detection function, fire alarm function. At least one alarm device must be remain in use. Fire resistant cables, a single error in any individual transmission path cannot prevent. Initiating a fire signal in an area greater than that allowed for a single detection zone, or the sounding of fire alarm in an area larger than allowed for a single alarm zone, or operating of all alarm devices in the building, at least one alarm device will continue to operate. Okay, let's talk about cables and interconnections. Protection against fire. The cables that need to work for one more minute after the fire detected must be resistant to fire and firefighting for at least 30 minutes or must be reinforced to withstand this time. These cables may include connections between the control and display equipment with separate power supply apparatus, alarm devices, power supplies, including links between them, connections between the separated parts of control and indicating equipment, controls between main control and indicating equipment and repeater indicating equipment, the links between the main control and indicator equipment and the repeater control equipment, cables that should work after a certain delay to investigate the fire. Rotary lines, these should comply with one of following. The occurrence of fire must be passed through an area covered by fire detection devices causing an alarm condition. It must be resistant to fire or firefighting at least 30 minutes, or it must be reinforced to survive during this period. A signal and supply cables from fire control panels, audible and light warning devices, voice evacuation system, amplifiers and speakers in emergency control devices. The parts of the cables used to inform firefighters and firefighters within the building. The parts of the cables used to inform firefighters and firefighters within the building. The communication and supply cables between main fire control panel and secondary fire control panels and repeater panels. Supply cables supplying energy to all fire control panels and repeater panels. It must be capable with standing at least 60 minutes against fire. The last part, continuing with cables and interconnections. Cables that must be resistant to fire must be tested and certified in accordance with the relevant standards. Fire resistance features may not be required in fire in manual call points, detectors and cables between fire control panels and cables that goes to electromagnetic doors, door holders and similar devices that do not have dangerous situations when the power is cut off after the fire is detected. Fire alarm cables must be reinforced at least 60 minutes against fire. Thank you for your participation. If you have any question, you can send it to export@mavili.com.tr. Also, please follow us from Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram and YouTube with Mavili Electronic Global Account. We are sharing webinar links in Mavili Electronic Global Account via LinkedIn, via our LinkedIn account. If you have any question, I can answer it. You can write it on the chat menu. Okay, thank you, Mr. Philip. Okay, I guess you don't have any question. Mr. Bashar, it is actually writing on our project design catalog. But I cannot remember the certain time. If you can send an email about this topic to export@mavili.com.tr, we will reply it about it. But I don't want to give wrong information about it. It is actually depends on the location. If the location is, if there is always a people in the location to control the fire alarm control panel, it depends the time. But if there is no people, no security guy for there, it's also depending. It should be stand about 72 hours, but I'm not sure about it if there is no people. If there is a people to control it, I guess it was 24 hours, but I am not sure about these numbers. For the certain answer, I will, if you can send mail, I will reply it with this certain times, okay? Okay then, great. If nobody has any other question, shall we finish for today? Okay, what is your question? Actually, we don't recommend any cable or any other systems because we don't want to use that responsibility. We are just recommend our systems because if we recommend some companies and if they are not good enough, we will be get in trouble. That's why we don't recommend any other companies. But you can find cables from everywhere actually. In Turkey you can also find very good suppliers. But as I said before, I cannot recommend any company. I actually don't know any company about the cables. Yes, sure. With our supervisor software, it is sending SMS, mails, or reminders also it is sending to your phone. We had in Androids before, but now we developed it, and for iOS you can also use our application. But you need to, the mobile part is optional. You need to purchase it for the mobile part. It is optional. Also, we have the, as you know, some of them, I guess you know, but I need to tell it. We have also Hikvision partnership. We are the only partner for the fire alarm system. I don't know, you know, the Hikvision CCTV cameras from China, China's brand. We have the only integration for the Hikvision system. And we have plugin in HikCentral software. Thanks to our supervisor software, it is plugged in HikCentral. Actually, it is not. Is it addressable or conventional? For the sounder question. Because if it is addressable, it is connecting on the loop line. No other cables. You don't need to use any other cables. For the cable cross section, if the cable cross section is 1.5 millimeter or 1.5 centimeter, the loop line distance will be different. We have three options: 0.8, 1. And 1.5, if I remember it correctly. For the 1.5 cross section, it will be, I guess it was 2 kilometer for the loop line, if I don't remember it wrongly. But I will send the project design book we have. I will send it to you, Mr. Philip. And also the detectors detection areas, also writing in there. And we have also Revit. I don't know. Do you know the Revit software? It is for the project. It is using for the project design for the fire alarm, or it is like an AutoCAD software. We put the detection areas and other parts of project design rules. We put them on Revit software. If you have it, we will send you the Revit library, our Revit library, and you can use it in project design when you are designing your project. How many detectors you need to use, you can see it very easily. It is like an object we integrated to Revit software. Detectors, manual call points, sounders, fire alarm control units, fire alarm panels. We put them in Revit with detection areas, detection distances, and other things. Also, I will also send the our project design catalog. Okay. What is the PIDS system? I don't know that actually. Can you open it? Explain it. Okay, I guess you want to send. Did you heard my answer, Mr. Philip? Because I'm not sure my microphone is muted or not. Okay then, let's finish for today. If you don't have any other question, we are waiting you for next week, same time at 10 a.m. for GTM Plus 3. We will share the link on our LinkedIn account with Mavile Elektronik Global. Thank you for your participation again. Have a nice day.